Dashboard should be updated. We should be good. I had a it's weird. I had kind of a weird gut feeling about Homefront Revolution. And I don't know, maybe the game gets better. Maybe like the story gets better. Maybe the story is actually really good. It's just I don't know, the gunplay doesn't feel tight. It feels like too loose and enemies feel unusually spongy. When you can just like stab their neck. Like I kind of expect if I shoot you in the head and I don't hit your helm, but I hit, you know, the cloth between your mouth, I expect you to drop like a sack of potatoes. If you don't drop, I feel weird. I feel like Borderlands-ish, you know, Division style. All right, let's pick up some goodies here. What do we got? What do we got? What do we got? Honestly, though, I feel like Doom, Uncharted 4, mainly just Doom. Doom kind of spoiled me on the whole shooting thing. It feels so good that when it feels off, it's off. Oh, sounds ticked. Come here, big boy. I need some mama. I think the plus side, for anyone that's getting like absolute motion sickness as I'm playing, we'll be going back to like, you know, games that move slower and easier to watch. That don't cause you to go, blah. I'll put it like this. I'll be doing a review for Homefront Revolution, but I don't think it's at the moment worth a buy. I don't even think it's worth a sale. It's just the shooting doesn't feel good. The controls don't feel good. It's just too much that doesn't feel right. I like the gun customization. I love the setting. I'm just... It just doesn't feel right. And it's kind of a disappointment just because, well, what might have killed the game is, if I remember correctly, it was... Get it. Homefront was a THQ title, right? Lost its publisher, then it's lost its studio, and then the game had to be reworked and rechanged and retooled. So it got a new publisher and then a new studio while maintaining a few other things. That might have hurt the game. Fee-fi-fo-fum! Come here, big boy! Go ahead and eat some. Already been up there. And that's finally down. Sweet! Besides, as far as I know, we are close to beating this game, and then... we'll be good. See, like, Doom, I would say, is an easy buy. Uncharted 4. Easy buy, right? Homefront, it's like deep sale. Like, I feel like if they patch it in, tweak it, it'll be fine. But there's a lot of patching that needs to be involved. Isn't that the only way to force feed a demon? I can't think of any other way. It is, and I hate to say that because I was actually looking forward to Homefront. Eat it! Leg sweep's a little tricky to do still. At least for me, anyway. But honestly, as far as I can tell, it probably would be best... Ooh, wait, hang on. Is that a... That's a lever. Okay. Okay, there must be a secret around here. Yep! Retro level somewhere. But honestly, it looks like Homefront's gonna be one of those deep sales. The thing is, I've noticed if I aim at the leg, I either get... He'll rip the leg off and, like, have them lick their boot. Or I get a leg sweep. It's like... I can't seem to get it just right yet. Ooh, hang on. Okay, I got enough on chainsaw. Ba-ba! Hey, big boy! Whoa! Sexy lady! Oh! Love this gun. Oh, sorry. And yow! I am not a huge Warhammer fan. However, I do love Dawn of War 2. I do love Space Marine. And I am super excited for Deathwing. It's from the same team, from what I'm hearing, the guys behind Vermintide. But it's a Warhammer 40k experience, and that sounds awesome. Also, the guys behind Van Helsing, the Diablo-inspired isometric-like RPG game, are doing a Warhammer version called Inquisitor, which looks really good. And if you didn't know this, Battlefleet... like Gothic Armada, also really good. I've been playing that off stream, like, a lot. Be my piñata! Be my piñata! I did see Dawn of War 3. Relic and THQ. Or not THQ. Well, is it? No, it's Sega. It's Sega. It's Relic and Sega. My only gripe. I have one tiny gripe, but we're still... We have yet to see how it work out. Is they're going back to base building, which I wasn't a huge fan of in Dawn of War 1. I felt like Dawn of War 2 felt really... It felt closer to what I kind of thought of what a Warhammer game should be when it came to an RTS. But I'm willing to see what they do with it, because, I mean, Relic does a great job in and of itself. Like, Dawn of War 2 is, like, one of my favorite RTSs of all time. That game just... that tickled my fancy in ways I never thought. And the funny thing is, I never got around to beating it, nor getting the expansions. Ah, violence, violence everywhere, not a drop to drink. Ooh, actually, you know what? You don't want to drink it. It'd be like the worst idea ever. Okay, now, where do I... okay, I didn't... oh, I did! I'm just being really dumb about that. I was like, man, I didn't get the yellow skull, did I? No, yeah, I did. The thing that has me really pumped for Dawn of War 3 is scale. Size and scale. And what we can see is it looks like there are units that are so big, they're massive on the actual battlefield. But the best part is you can have infantry that just... they have their uses. Nothing's, like, out of place, right? You don't, like, oh, I built around infantry, so I'm screwed. No, you can use them to your advantage if you know how. And I think that's something that I'm really excited for. That and the idea that you can have persistent units that last through an entire campaign, level them up very a la Homeworld, and, you know, go to town. Okay, everything's shaking, and I hear something. Oh! What's a VMMO? I know about Sword Art Online being an MMO, but I don't know what a VMMORPG is. Never heard of the... I don't know what the V stands for. Whoa, I think he's... oh yeah, he's totally dead. No, boy. Okay, so we might be... in a bit of trouble! Okay. Yeah! Yeah! Get it! A VR. Ooh. I don't know about that. I'm willing to see, but man, at the moment, I still get motion sickness with normal VR, dude. Like, it's sad. And oh, cheap son of a. Little bastards. I need some health and armor and ammo. Basically, can I just have everything back now? This looks really, really kind of cool too. Oh, hey. Okay, I'll take the armor. Ooh, I will totally take that. Thank you very much. Yeah. got a little bit of upgrades here. I completely spaced on what we were trying to upgrade, but... actually, you know what? I think we're just kind of like winging it. Yep, we're winging it. Let's see. What looks good? Kind of got everything I wanted. Oh, I guess we'll go with that. Lock on, send me for another candidate. Let's just do that. And let's see. What does this want me to do? Kill 5 Mancubi with each charge burst. I could do that, I think. Also, I swear to God, I keep forgetting about that. Like, the whole idea that I have a freaking BFG. Remote detonator. Gatling rotator. Let's go with precision. One down! Two down! Yeah! To say I got your eye just... Wait! Oh, crap. That was a wasted shot. Did not mean to use that. Come here, Buttercup. I will be your huckleberry. Yeah, see, I get it that time. But then I get that one, so... Yeah! Come here, baby! Papa loves you! Yeah! Oh, come on, man! I had that! That was mine! Cock block by a Mancubi. Ugh. That's a sentence you never want to hear in life. Need some mouth, boys. Oh, damn it! Oh, wait. Oh, that's right. Hang on. Let me fix this. I knew it. Yeah, that's not right. There we go. Thank you, Edie. Okay, that should... hang on. Okay, now, there we go. Says, I think we're actually a few levels away from being done with the game. Which would be great. Because then Valkyrie Chronicles and yada yada yada, which... Take a look here real quick. And go in here. Before I jump back in this. Yeah, the side note, the game that I'm thinking about jumping into before Valkyrie Chronicles is called... Just had it. Song of Seven, Chapter 1. It looks really kind of cool. It kind of looks, I don't know, semi-like a Pixar game? Like, the characters are somewhat blocky, and they look really, like, they have a full... It looks really, really good. Alright, come here, buddy. Yeah! Okay, the demons are fighting each other, which is awesome. And they're not even caring that I'm here. Which is weird, but I will take that. Yep, gotta go. man, I will totally take this. Come here, Buttercup. Who loves you? Daddy does. Come here. There we go. Got the shield here. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay, I really don't like acid. Okay, I know something is still alive. Okay, no joke. These guys are not fun to deal with.
Ready.
I'm trying to get that the shotgun bonus. I just need one more, and shotgun does not do really well from afar. The double barrel, the super shotty seems to be okay, but like the other shotguns, not so much. Well, the good thing is I gotta do one more time, so I kind of want to make sure that I have it before the final boss fight, because for whatever reason, it really helped me out in the final boss fight. Okay, there we go. Now, don't have to touch that until the final boss. Oh, hang on. Yep. Oh, hey. It's all right. Got it. Got it. Got it. You get a little bit of lovin', and you get a little bit of lovin'. You get a little bit of lovin'. It's lovin'. I will give Silky to all and any who want Silky. Silky happens to be, you know, super shoddy, but you know what? They're not complaining. Oh, Buttercup is down! Fee, fi, fo, fum! Get wrecked, son! Okay, who's else alive that needs to not be? Anything? Alright. Wait a minute. Am I supposed to jump over there, or is there a stray demon around? Is that what I'm missing right now? Like, I hear the combat music, and it's just, which is great, but yo, come here. Okay, yeah. Those stray imps are so fucking annoying sometimes. It's like, dude, just come to me.
Lana. Lana!
What? Danger zone.
Oh! The danger is me. Oh, what the hell? The
the danger is me! Yow! Oh, too many!
Super shoddy. Why would you need anything else? Oh, the 2-for-1. It's a guts.
Shane, hey buddy! Come here! Hell, it's about time.
Okay, I have a tingle, and the tingle is boss fight? Boss fights. Guardian boss fight, I think. I have a tingle in the forest, guys. It's kind of like Tingle from Legend of Zelda, so you can tell it's a bad thing when you get a tingle. Alright, if you guys didn't get that assay trip. It's funny, I had to go from one game to another, and yet the TR had to come on. Ugh. Yeah, I'm gonna rip that out like a chest poster. Let's go, Buttercup! Your mother wears high heels in hell. It's normally bad, trust me. He's pissed. Ah. Oh, damn it. Okay, come on, buddy. I got a bunch of lovey coconuts. What are you doing? Oh, okay, so.
Ready.
That sucked. I forgot about that attack. So basically, don't jump. Just keep going left or right. Or right, whatever you feel is acceptable, you know. Hey, I was doing pretty damn good there for a second. He's angry. Thank you. Whoa, the fire. Yes. Okay, and then he just does that, in which case I immediately die. So, like, I'm trying to get left. I get knocked back. The second I get knocked, so basically you cannot get hit once when he does that attack. Otherwise, you get staggered and you're dead. Good to know. All right, Junior Cupcake. Okay, don't you dare. Come on. Oh, there we go! Technically it's nicer, it's just not as nice. And... Booyah! Yeah, that's right, there's two of them. That moment when you're like, aww. Alright. Gotta take out one a-hole. Yep. Damn it! They are... Yeah. See, the thing is, I felt like I might have cheatsy dueled this guy out, because what I did is I used the other one as a block. So he would use his long-range attacks, and then, like, he couldn't do anything. It helped. It seriously helped. Also had the ability to stagger him, so I don't know why I can't stagger him, but that's okay. I'm trying to use my super shoddy in the best possible ways. Make it a college effort. I gotta move around more. Get him! First we crack the shell, then we crack the nut inside. My turn! Hey, little one. Come here! Wait, as in, like... Well, actually, that's not surprising. Yesterday, I couldn't talk in anyone's chat either. And this morning, I had issues chatting in a few streams, too. See, I see this, and I'm like, man. It's obviously like a Templar order, right? Designed to maybe fight the Hell Dimension, or just, I don't know, maybe they're angelic? But I'm more curious about the Doom Marine. Because of, like, all the little subtle things here and there all over the place. Than the actual main story to the game. It's so weird. Because, let's be honest, the main story to this game is, hey, somebody wants to open a hell portal. You gotta close it. That's it. That's it. That's all. It's not bad. It kicks you into the world and be like, yeah, go at it. I am Vega. All right, we got 10 of these. What do I want to put this in? All right, let's do that. And get 15 headshot kills with each charged energy shot. Get 20 direct hits on imps. Okay, we'll go ahead and equip that. Kill 4 or more demons using a single mobile turret. Deploy 5 times. Within 5 seconds. Yeah, let's do that. Why not?
You have the crucible. Contain the power of the well. We have a plan to send you there. Vega will walk you through the process.
Okay, not gonna lie. I do feel like Samuel Hayden reminds me of Optimus Prime. And at any moment, he's gonna let me know about, like, the Matrix of Leadership.
It takes approximately 2.4 terawatts of power to sustain my operational capabilities, but it has been decided that we can use that power to send you to the source of the portal. I will not survive the procedure and am unable to self-terminate, so I will walk you through the process. All interior and exterior facility doors have been secured. You will need to begin by finding
Ooh, hello, okay.
and disabling the security systems.
Grab that, don't mind if I do. I really need to learn to use my BFG more. Like, I don't seem to ever really use it, and I should. Okay. It's cute. Hey, little buddy! Okay, did that count? Hang on. That was a direct hit, right? Get 20 direct hits on imps. Apparently that didn't work. That's weird, right? Hang on. I'm doing that wrong somehow. Okay. Getting a direct hit with an explosive shot will spawn cluster bombs that deal additional damage. Get 20 direct hits on imps. I'm hitting them directly. Yeah, that's like... Okay, maybe not. Like, it barely missing, but still killing. Damn.
Turn terminate in this maintenance facility. Each termination point is protected by an electrified field, but you should survive the surge.
Should? Okay. You know, you're gonna get electrified. You should be able to handle it. I mean, you know. No worries. Okay, here we go. Woohoo! Okay. Oh, come on, man! Can't you see I'm trying to do something here? Oh! You know what? This might have a better effect. Oh, yeah! Okay, maybe not. Pull it down. Look right behind you. Okay, pop. Oh, damn. Okay, you know that moment when you're like, you totally got cocky? That is me getting cocky. Trying to get that shotgun up to be, like, up to snuff, but... you know what? I won't worry about it. We're just gonna go in, use what we gotta, kick ass, take names, a few numbers, and go with it. Alright, gonna need this, and we're gonna need this. Alright, here we go. And I just now realized that there is a Berserk power-up that I did not notice. I hate when that happens. Oh, don't touch it. Ooh. Wait, I saw one glowy. Come here. Ah, who loves you, baby? Who loves you? Woo! Okay, grab it! Look behind you! Oh! Yeah! Come here! I got a lovely little secret. Okay, anyone else? Yeah! Come here, little imp! Come here! Where'd you go? Little buddy! The ancient weapons would be cool. Co-op, man, I don't know. I mean, you could ideally just throw more guys at the issue, but I'm always weary when I see shooters do that. I lean towards the idea that they will give more mechanics to an enemy versus, you know, that. Okay, you know what? Booyah! Oh, that would explain the...